Miles, this is my best friend.
He's gonna put you back in jail or he's gonna get you killed.
What's the thing you love most about working with your best friend?
Because we know each other so well, we know how to help each other get through the harder moments. And then you come out at the end of it and you spend all this time as a young person being like, oh, how cool would it be if we were like in a movie or something? Every once in a while, I'll be sitting in a theater where, we don't watch it that often, but when we do, I always have that pullback moment where I'm like, this is crazy. This is nuts.
No, you can't catch me, I'm on too fast.
What's the thing you like least about working with your best friend?
Well, for me, like the hardest scene was the scene where we're yelling at each other because it's so far away from how we've ever interacted. Mm-hmm. And that's the one scene, I say this all the time, that's the one scene where it would have been easier to do with like somebody I didn't actually care about.
Right.
So, it was a long, exhausting scene and we would like, you finish walking in opposite directions. We come in behind the warehouse and just like, you okay? You all right? Sorry, I hit you a little hard there. Is that all right? Okay, we're ready to go? All right, and do another take.
Sometimes when you throw a lot of themes into a film, it can become muddled. This just felt like it was everyday life, and I was trying to kind of count them, whether it was, police brutality or, the criminalization of brown people or privilege or what. I mean, there was just so much, but it just felt like it felt like a song, there you go. If that's what I'm looking for, it felt like life.
And it's a snapshot of
you
life.
Guys did this 10 years ago, but damn it, you could have written it yesterday.
Well, we wrote it for 10 years. We didn't write it 10 years ago, right?
Well, so, there like, you go, you're right. You started it 10 years ago.
So part of the work was every time we came back to sort of updating it and making sure that it felt true to right now. But I think that revelation that all of those themes can sit in a film and work together says more about that, like, we're all dealing with a lot of stuff actually,
yeah.
Right? That feels honest is like,
gentrification,
kind of
that was in there too.
Yeah.
Yeah, we don't have like a one theme day ever. Yeah. We exist simultaneously with all the conditions of the country.
Not enough. Stop!
The nature of the conversation around these police shootings has changed a great deal. And when we started writing was right after Oscar Grant was murdered at the Fruitvale Bar Station. His name was everywhere. His face was on T-shirts. And we protested and we rioted a little bit.
Yeah.
And the fantasy of that time was that something would change. Particularly with it was intentionally publicizing these tragedies, right? Making sure that people knew about them. I think what we're ready for right now is a discussion that involves more nuance than we've ever allowed ourselves before. Mm-hmm. And that's sort of what we argue for in the film is that everybody is complicated and every circumstance is complicated. We don't demonize the police officer, what I'm saying? It's another human who has his own movie going on that isn't this movie.
Absolutely.
I hope the evolution of the conversation is like, we're like a clapback country right now.
Yeah. Yes.
Everybody's just like, here's my retort with a little bit of attitude
to further cement my
side, right? That's the era of Twitter. Like, here's my 140 character retort. At some point we'll have a rejection of that and it'll be like, I actually don't engage on that level anymore. I will not engage with you on this clapback thing. We're always looking to like tear down the perfect person who is the ambassador of the opinion we agree with. And it's like, no, that is a false notion. There are no perfect characters in this film. Mm-hmm. Everyone is flawed and struggling. I mean, we all are flawed and pushing forward and trying to progress as people. But blind spots are not exclusive to people of privilege. Blind spots are across the board. They are the product of the fact that you exist in one vessel from one experience in the world. So we're all susceptible to them, and we all inherently have them. So that's a collective work, right? Now, the systemic problems we have favor people of privilege,
right?
And so the conversation of awareness is up, but the conversation about blind spots is universal, and that's, I feel like that to me is the entry point to the conversation. Let's all acknowledge that we don't all know everything about this circumstance. Let's just talk about our vantage point into our lived experience and see if we can find empathy.
Let's hope. Amen, because right now I think we're in a stuck situation. Mm-hmm. But I will see you guys during award season.
Let's get the movie out.